The biggest difference between marine robotics and, let's say, ground or air is that as soon as we put the vehicle in water, we don't have information about the vehicle. We don't have the GPS. Marine robots, they perform based on a pre-planned motion. They go, they do their pattern, and then they come to surface after a certain time. They tell us, okay, I'm here. And then we get the data and we get, you know, we plan for the next stage. So that's the biggest challenge. Usually right now, the vehicle runs out of the battery and we get it out. We recharge it, we take the data out, and then we put it in water. This is very expensive. What if there was a portable docking station that it could work for any type of autonomous underwater vehicle? Roomba does vacuum cleaning, and then when it runs out of the battery, it autonomously go back to a dock and it gets recharged. This is exactly what I want to do in a more challenging environment. Not just have one dock, have multiple, spread out, and have it mobile. Extend your life and it gives you mobility without human intervention. I am an aerospace engineer by training. I got introduced to marine robotics. The same thing, more challenge. The underwater environment, it is ever changing. This is our challenge. We are responding to that challenge.